Rafi, is home a place?
Ina, home is a feeling or just an idea.
Rafi, home is Hayastan.
Home is wherever I lay my hat down.
But it's the land under our feet, the air that we breathe, and the mountains that we see in a distance.
Ina, home is just another one of those four-letter words. Love and home.
No, home is where you were born and raised, Rafi.
Oh, come on.
No, listen.
Wait.
How can you say that?
Okay.
Can we agree on something, Rafi?
Yeah.
Home is where the heart is. Where is home?
We'll find the answer with someone new every Friday night from 9 to 10 with Ina.
And Rafi.
Homesick at home.
Have you ever felt that way?
Shy City.
I'm coming home again.
Good evening, dear listeners of Radio Van 103.1. This is our evening English-speaking show, Homesick at Home. And tonight, I'm kind of alone here, but I'm not alone, of course, because I have two guests in my studio. Rafi has left me, but I hope soon he will be back. And tonight, we are hosting very special two guests, father and son, from America, John and Knut Remem. Good evening, guys.
Good evening.
Hi.
How are you doing?
We're doing good.
You don't have to come closer to the microphone. You can just lean back and speak because it's quite powerful. We can hear you. So how are you doing?
Good.
Good?
Good.
Tell us, how did you end up in Armenia?
I just visited.
Yeah, we're here on a visit, a vacation for 10 days.
Mm-hmm.
And this is our second time to Armenia. We were here 10 years ago. And we had a wonderful visit then. Of course, Knut was very little at that point, so he didn't remember much of it. So we have been recreating and reliving our first visit with Knut.
I remember most of it being in my... on my dad's belly in the baby carrier.
No, do you really remember it?
Kind of.
Well, from the stories that your mom and dad told you.
Yeah.
I bet you did. And so I'm going to reveal a little secret here. I met this guys on the 10th of June, and we're already friends. And so I decided to invite them to our show because this is pretty amazing how people visit Armenia 10 years ago and now they decided to come here again and with their son because they want Knut to know more about Armenia. So you're originally from where?
I am from Norway. I grew up in Norway, lived in the United States for many, many years now.
How long? How long has it been?
I can't count that high anymore.
Oh, so it's been long.
But yeah, since I was in college, I went to college in the United States, right. And been living there ever since.
So, well, how did you decide to move there? Is that because you studied in college or?
I went there to study and. Mm-hmm. With no big plans of staying in the United States other than to study, and life just happened, and you know, you got a job and car and house and wife and now a son.
Yeah. This is too fast. Just a second. I never ask you how you met, how you guys, you and Pam met. By the way, hello, Pam. Hello. How are you doing? Pam is listening to us right now. Pam is Knut's mom and Jordan's wife. Mm-hmm. So yeah, you can say hello to her on air right now.
Hi.
That was short.
How's it going?
She's answering you, I'm pretty sure. So how did you guys meet, you and Pam?
We met through a common friend of ours. We both knew the same person and we were both invited to the same party,
mm-hmm.
You know, surprise, surprise, in college. And we met and we hit it off, and very shortly thereafter, the same friend, mm-hmm. had two extra tickets to U2 concert.
Oh,
and so she
cool.
decided to, and totally independent of what we knew, she decided to give one ticket to each of us. And so we ended up at a U2 concert together, and the rest is history, as they say.
Yeah, he just happened to have two extra tickets to the U2 concert. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Ironic.
Ironic, right. So that's where it all started, U2. Yeah. Do you have your special song that is your and Pam's? U2, maybe? No?
No, I don't know that we ever... Kind of, I mean, we like U2. We listen to U2. Listen to U2 a lot more before, back then. But I don't know if there was ever was a single song that kind of stood out among. There are so many good songs for U2 that it's difficult to pick one.
Okay, and now I think we know what we have on air later tonight. And what do you do, Jorn?
I am the director of operations for a food company that makes potato chips and salty snacks.
Yeah.
So, very good stuff.
Yummy. So, yeah. Do you get to eat them every now and often?
Oh, yeah.
Do they let you eat them very often, your parents?
Every now and then.
Oh, good.
When there's, like, neighborhood parties and stuff, they bring... some, and then when we watch movies, we eat them.
So I don't get a lot of chips for Sasha. No, not that often.
Man,
by the way, is your mom traveling along with you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I know that. You know that I know that she's here, but I want to hear it from you. So, dear listeners. Pam is in our studio, not in our studio, but at our radio station, and she's listening and cheering up for her family. Stay tuned. This is Homesick at Home. We're going to have a little advertisement break, and we're going to come back with more questions for Jorn and Knut Remem. We have wonderful guests from America, and we're going to discover how come they ended up in Armenia. Homesick at Home.
Radio One. Համով լուր ավանի բնակիչների համար։
Կարասը բացել է իր 14-րդ մասնաճյուղն արդեն նաև ավանում, խուդյակով 175 կոտորակ 1 հասցեում։
Կարաս 32-55-55, հիմա մենք ավելի մոտ ենք ձեզ։
Пока все купаются, мы работаем. Мы работаем. Реклама на Радио One. Работает, работает и работает. Ինչու ներբեռնել Vivaro Sportsbook հավելվածը. Արագությունն ու հարմարավետությունը պլյուս, ուղիղ հեռարձակվող խաղերի դիտումը պլյուս, շահումի մասին ծանոթումը պլյուս, բոնուսների ու ակցիաների մասին ծանոթումը պլյուս. Vivaro Sportsbook եւ Android եւ iOS համակարգերի համար առանց մինուսների. Մանրամասները vivaro.am կայքում.
Mezzo Classic House Club – это великолепная кухня, это огромный выбор суши, это богатая винная карта, это потрясающая атмосфера с живой музыкой. И вдобавок ко всему, если у вас день рождения, это бесплатный вход для вас и ваших гостей. Заходите на Исаакяна 28, резервируйте места по телефону 098-206-206. Mezzo Classic House Club.
Воспитанные куколки снимают все, кроме шляп. Ночной клуб «Синди» – шоу-программа с участием любимых исполнителей и не только. Ночной клуб «Синди» по новому адресу Мясникяна, 36/3. «Синди» – 099-90-69-69.
Երևանում թեժ ամառ է, Վիելվիում թեժ գներ, գնեք օդակարգավորիչ ընդամենը 89,000 դրամով, շտապեք, հապարիկը տեղում միայն անձնագրով և սոցքարտով, կատարեք գնումներ և մասնակցեք հուլիսի 2-ին կայանալիք ավտոմեքենայի և այլ տեխնիկայի խաղարկությանը, Վիելվի տեխնիկա բոլորի համար, հեռախոս 34-99-44.
Для рекламы звоните 540002.
Rafi, are you sick of being homesick?
I am, and you know, misery loves company.
Want to talk about that?
Let's talk about that.
Chi lavel tanavorvel es.
Homesick at Home.
English-speaking show.
I
wish I found some better sounds no one's ever heard. I wish I had a better voice and sang some better words. I wish I found some chords in an order that is new. I wish I didn't have to rhyme every time I sang. I was told when I get older all my fears would shrink, but now I'm insecure and I care what people think.
My name's Blurry Face and I care what you think. My name's Blurry Face and I care what you think. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep but now we're stressed out.
Smell will take me back to when I was young. How come I'm never able to identify where it's coming from? I'd make a candle out of it if I ever found it. Try to sell it, never sell out of it. I'd probably only sell one. Maybe to my brother, cause we have the same nose, same clothes, homegrown, a stone's throw from a creek we used to roam. But it would remind us of when nothing really mattered. Out of student loans and treehouse homes, we all would take the ladder.
My name's Blurry Face and I care what you think. My name's Blurry Face. And I care what you think. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep but now we're stressed out. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep but now we're stressed out.
Used to play pretend, give each other different names. We would build a rocket ship and then we fly it far away. Used to dream of outer space, but now they're laughing at the face, saying, wake up, you need to make money. Yeah. We used to play pretend, give each other different names. We would build a rocket ship and then we fly it far away. Used to dream of outer space, but now they're laughing at the face, saying, wake up, you need to make money. Yeah. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep, but now we're stressed out. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep, but now we're stressed out.
Used to play pretend, used to play pretend, bunny. We used to play pretend, wake up, you need the money. Used to play pretend, used to play pretend, bunny. We used to play pretend, wake up, you need the money. Used to play pretend, give each other different names. We would build a rocket ship and then we'd fly far away. Used to dream of outer space, but now they're laughing at the face, saying, wake up, you need to make money.
Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play.
Whoa, I haven't seen a single deer nor antelope in Armenia.
We have the zoo. Homesick at home. We're back in the studio. For those of you who just tuned in, we have two wonderful guests tonight, father and son, Jorn and Knut Remem. Hi, guys, again.
Hi.
Hi again.
So I have to mention that this song, Stressed Out, was on air especially for Knut, because this is one of his favorite songs. And by the way, he used to perform this song. So I want to hear this story right now. Please, please go ahead. Young man, this is your fame minute. Minute of fame. Go ahead.
Okay. So every summer, this place in America called Twin Town Guitars. Mm-hmm. It's like a guitar store that has lots of guitars. You could buy guitars. Play guitars. They have drums, but they're mostly guitars. And they have camps there where one person from Twin Town that works at Twin Town, people sign up to be in a band, and then you have a little group for a band that that person runs, and they talk about music and what music they want to play, and this is 2 weeks long. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Mm-hmm. And then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And on the last Friday, we always have a performance either at this place called the Whiskey Junction, which is like a...
It's a renowned rock club in Minneapolis. They have a lot of good big acts in, and it is very famous. And
I'm sitting here with the celebrities, guys. Okay, so
seriously?
Seriously. So what did you do? You sang your song there?
Yeah, I sang most of Stressed Out that you just heard.
Were there a lot of applause?
Yeah, there's lots of applause because there's lots of people.
Cool.
Lots and lots and
That's
lots and
amazing.
Lots and lots of people.
So what do you want to be when you grow up? You want to sing?
I want to be an actor. You know, like
an actor?
An actor in
and
a movie.
A singer.
Maybe. Want to be a singer
yeah,
too.
You could combine.
And a comedian. That's important.
Amazing. But is there any musical instruments that you play, Knut?
Oh, yeah. This may take a while. You know it won't.
Yeah, go ahead. We had
keyboard, piano, synthesizer, recorder,
drum.
A very talented young man. What else? Is there anything else?
African hand drum.
Any Armenian instruments you play or you would like to learn?
Well, play? I'm going to learn how to play a duduk.
Wow.
Is that how I say it? I say it right?
Yeah,
yes.
It's you got it right.
Yeah, you. I did it.
So why do you like duduk in particular?
I don't know. It's just
you like
cool.
The sound.
It looks really cool.
So are you gonna practice back at home, or are you gonna start
probably.
Now?
I'm probably going to need to practice back at home.
Cool. Do you have a duduk back home?
No. Here in Armenia right now, I'm going to get one.
Ah, that's amazing. So, and what is so special about Armenia, Knut?
Well, there's lots of really, really cool, really, really old stuff like Garni, Gerhardt.
So you've been to those places?
Yeah, I've been to those two places.
Where else?
Cascades. I've been to the Cascades. I have been...
Any museums you've visited?
Well, I've been to a lot of museums.
What did you like it the most about
the museum? I liked all the, like, the older stuff. The really old stuff.
Okay, got
and
you.
All the museums...
You like history.
Yeah, history.
Is this your favorite subject at school? History?
It isn't.
Or no?
It isn't.
I hear you because mine wasn't either.
And I'm not really a museum man. My mom makes me go to the museums.
Do you want to tell her something about it on air right now? Mom, don't take me to any more museums.
I take that back because she's listening to it.
Okay. So, Yorin, what are the five things you love about Armenia? Can you name
Wait,
them?
Wait, I was
right
supposed
now?
To do five.
Well, you guys could do both.
Okay.
It's the history. The history is amazing in Armenia. I mean, it is. There is a lot of, very old. Gerhard Garni, he mentioned we went to the Folk Museum, we went to the Armenian History Museum here in Republic Square, and you see things that go back and the amount of people who lived here and the kind of arts and crafts and the trades. I mean, it's fascinating to see that. So the history in Armenia is definitely very, very fascinating. I also really like, walking around in Yerevan. People are super friendly, very nice. It's a very walkable city, a lot of parks and outside places. Everybody is sitting around at cafes and having coffees and eating dinner. And it's just a very nice atmosphere to walk around in. So I don't know if that was five, but
that was two. Okay, museums, history, what else? You can be, it's not necessarily that you name like items or places. You can you can be name both emotions. Yeah. How do you feel? For instance, I don't know, safe.
Well, an emotion.
Yes.
I'm sleepy because I'm from America and it's a 9 hours
time difference. Okay, so
when
you go back home and you will think about Armenia, you will see, oh, how sleepy I was in Armenia.
Yeah, it's gonna be a shock.
Is that what's gonna happen?
Do you like the food in Armenia?
Yeah, I like the food in Armenia.
Yeah, what's your favorite food?
Lavash.
Lavash is very good.
So tell us a little bit about lavash. What do you know about
well,
it?
This isn't really any history or anything I know about lavash.
But
like a few days ago, me, my dad, my mom, and...
And someone else.
We went to this like lavash cafe place where we got to see these people make lavash, and they had this really cool way of spinning the lavash, and then they put it on a big pillow and slapped it against.
So, was it neat? Did you like it?
Oven? Yeah, I liked it.
Cool. You know a lot about lavash now.
I do.
Did you know that lavash is listed in UNESCO World Heritage? As a cultural value? So, now you know one more thing about lavash. So,
that's cool.
I want to ask you guys, what are the weirdest things that you can say about Armenia, like that you experienced? What is weird, funny, or any stories that you have to tell? Maybe 10 years back, Jorn can share something.
I got some really good ones.
Yeah,
I got some stories here.
Go ahead.
So, I was a very dangerous baby back then, because... I almost got my parents arrested, and I almost got my dad punched, which are two different stories.
How is that?
So, getting my dad punched, we were all, well, I didn't actually get him punched, but he almost got punched. So, we were at a Armenian church, and everybody was standing, and I was a baby, so I didn't really know better, and I was... touching the girl's hair in front of us.
Uh-huh.
And after a while, she spun around, ready, thinking it was my dad.
Oh, no way.
And then she saw me and she went, oh, it's the little baby. Well.
That story has a happy ending. Good.
Yeah, it does. This one does too. So, we were leaving Armenia to go home, and our taxi person dropped us off at the front of the airport line. I was in a baby carrier, and we got to the front of the line, and people noticed, they just walked in, what? They just walked into the front of the line. What's going on here? And they got angry, and then people got really angry, and then they started shouting.
But they never saw that you were there, right?
Yeah, they never saw that I was tucked in there, half asleep, and eventually the police came and was walking up to my mom and goes, excuse me? And she turns around and everybody sees me and
they go like,
now I see. Yep, yep.
Oh, it's okay. Go ahead. You're with a baby. Yeah, just go forward.
Go.
You see how Armenian people treat kids. They definitely respect kids, right? So, how would you define Armenian people?
Nice. Okay, here we go. Mm-hmm. Nice. Kind.
Mm-hmm.
Are those... I think that was the same thing. Anyway, helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Am I just saying the same word in different ways?
No, it's okay. Just go ahead.
Nice, kind, helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Friendly.
It can be really funny.
Uh-huh.
That's all I have.
What about your dad?
I think a lot of the same. I mean, we're a little bit at a disadvantage because we really don't speak the language, so we can't communicate very well, and a lot of Armenians don't speak very well English. So we have a little bit of a disadvantage there, but everybody that we run into has been super friendly and very, very open and very welcoming. And you know, Armenia is a comfortable country to visit because you feel safe, you feel comfortable. You know, you don't feel like you could get in trouble like you do some places, and right. and so yeah, we really enjoy being here, and it's wonderful and interesting, and we're having a great time.
By the way, what is your favorite food or drink here?
Fresh lavash right out of the lavash
like
oven.
Father like son.
Yeah,
okay.
That is hard to beat. I really like the Armenian barbecue, mm-hmm. and the barbecue vegetables. The vegetables and the fruit and vegetables here are also very fantastic, like the apricots, the tomatoes. I mean, they're kind of like grown the old-fashioned way, not like in the United States where everything right. is like factory made, and mm-hmm. and so yeah, you kind of feel like the food is nice and healthy and great, and we really, anyway, it's something we don't normally eat. I mean, I've tried to make barbecue vegetables in the United States because we love them so much, and we just can't replicate it.
So now, every time you want barbecue vegetables, you need to come back here to Armenia, okay? Deal?
Deal. We'll be back.
Okay. Are you guys going to come back anytime soon?
Absolutely.
Adding on to, we're not able really to speak Armenian. Ordering food is really hard.
Yeah. Well, there are some translated menus, though, right?
Yeah, there are.
Menus
but, like,
with pictures are easy.
talking to the person.
Yeah, I see what you're saying.
That is a problem.
Okay.
Except if they speak English, then life is good.
Then what would you recommend to people who are planning a trip to Armenia?
Here we go. Garni, Gerhardt, Cascades, Opera House.
Those are sites. What else?
Give them any advice.
What?
Ooh.
What about you, Jorn?
Yeah,
before Knut takes time to think.
As far as sightseeing, or just as far as preparing?
Anything.
You know, I think, you know, one of the things that is helpful, and I don't know that you need to know a lot of Armenian, but knowing a few words is helpful because there is a lot of people don't speak English here.
Like Schnorr Hakalutsen.
Like saying Schnorr Hakalutsen, yeah. and we picked up a few phrases the first time we came. We didn't pick up quite as many before we came the second time, but that would be helpful. Other than that, you know, there is so many things to see, and we haven't seen half of it, or even, you know, a fraction of what's to see here, but there is so many interesting things, and I would just highly recommend people to come and, you know, kick back and enjoy the country and the culture and the people and have a great time.
And don't go in the front of the plane line.
And so, I have another question for you guys. Since our show is called Homesick at Home, you know.
I already know it.
Yeah, you already know it. And I'll first ask Jorn, because he's originally from Norway, and then he moved to America. So now he's in Armenia, and for the second time. So what are these phases of being homesick? Do you feel homesick for Norway, for instance? And where is your home now?
Well, I think my home now is the United States.
Okay.
I've lived there longer than anywhere else.
But were you homesick for Norway when you first moved to the United States?
I was. I still am to a certain degree. I mean, there are things that I miss about about Norway. Mm-hmm. And when I go visit Norway, there is things I miss about the United States. And,
right.
And, you know, it's been 10 years since I was here last, but there was things I missed about Armenia. And, you know, and we're here for such a short period now that there isn't a lot of stuff I miss about the United States, but it'll be good to come back home again. So, you know, no matter where you are in the world, there are a lot of other great, interesting places and that you either long for or miss, that you would like to go back and visit again, but that doesn't mean you are like desperate to go back.
Okay, but what are the things you miss the most now about the U.S.?
What, the U.S. right now?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know that I miss the U.S. quite yet. In a while, I might, you know, miss some of the regular things like food and, mm-hmm. You know, we have a dog and pets at home, and we miss those, of course. And, you know, it's something about sleeping in your own bed. The hotel here in Yerevan is wonderful, but it's not your own bed. So after a while, you kind of go like, oh, it would be nice to just be home.
So home is where the pillow is, ladies
home
and gentlemen.
Home is where the pillow is.
Yep.
What about you?
Okay.
Young man. What do you miss about home?
Okay.
Except your dog and
United,
the cats?
United States. Well.
Is that your home?
Technically right now, but...
Do you feel home here? Do you have the feeling that this is your home as well?
Yeah, I do.
I wonder why.
Well,
because
he was born here.
Yeah, I was born.
Wow. Yay! Amazing.
Okay.
Okay.
So, I also have two places that I need to talk about.
Sure, go ahead.
So, United States. I miss my treehouse.
Mm-hmm.
Going outside and playing. That's important. Because I can't really, like, go outside and just hang out.
So you miss your friends. Do you want to say hello to your friends right now? Who do you want to say hi to?
Well, I don't think they'd be really listening to this.
Well, you're going to have the recording later, so you're going to...
Oh, yeah, I will.
You have to show it to them.
Okay. Hello. You know what? It's going to take too long. I'm just going to say hi, everybody I know that I'm friends with. Now, I also miss having a car. I know we have a driver
here. Do you have a car back home?
Yeah, I do.
Wow. Is it a real car?
Well, no, I don't have a car, but my parents do. They drive it.
Okay. Now I see.
Yeah.
And
that's it.
Okay, gotcha. Will you come to Armenia again?
I think I already answered this, but yeah.
When?
Of course I will. That is
that is a question to your parents.
Yeah.
Mom?
We will definitely come back, but
maybe
we'll
another
have to,
10 years.
Yeah, we'll have to finish this trip before we make new plans.
Okay, so if you were to live, I have a question, like a totally different from what we were speaking to earlier. So get ready. If you were to live on a deserted island for the rest of your life, what would you take with you?
Let's see, these are kind of important. My TV and my game console.
Mm-hmm.
A sailboat.
Do you think you can turn it on there?
There's not going to be an outlet, but I could, if they have lemons, maybe I can use that, but... What else? I would bring a book.
Mm-hmm.
Well, 5,000 books.
Yeah, tell us about your books, by the way. What are you reading now?
Okay, this may take a while.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, there's lots of series I read.
Mm-hmm.
There's one called Diary of a Wimpy Kid.
Mm-hmm.
It's about this boy doing stuff, having a normal life, and weird stuff happens to him.
Mm-hmm.
What L?
We have an amazing guest who plays on who plays drums, piano, who loves reading, who sings, wants to become an actor. He loves Armenia. He loves animals. Do you have any like bad sides, or are you this perfect guy?
maybe we can
ask your parents. Jörn?
Well, let me get up and list you.
Is this an angel sitting with us in this studio?
No.
Okay.
He is.
I have stolen candy out of the cupboard before.
Oh, now it's not
sharp. I shouldn't have said that.
He is really good. He's a good student, and he's a fun little person to be with, and he is
this is how Armenians are.
Yeah, you know? And for the most part he is very happy. He's really cranky.
Excuse me?
Yes, really, but every once in a while you can be. So he is really good and he's really talented.
No, it's now your turn. Is Jörn a strict father?
Here we go. This is what my mom said. He's a strict marshmallow.
This is what my mom.
He's strict.
Quote.
But then he's also a nice little marshmallow.
Is that true? Is that true?
I think that's pretty true.
Mom?
Mom confirms. I bet she's doing this. You know, she's doing like this. And I think we are going for another music break, an advertisement break. Okay, I'm sorry. So stay tuned. This is Homesick at Home. We have another 20 minutes to go with our Remem family. It's amazing to hear all these nice stories and interesting stories about their life and their visit to Armenia.
Bye.
This is not bye. Well, this is 103.1 Radio Van.
Радио Ван. Пока все отдыхают, мы работаем. Мы работаем. Реклама на Радио Ван работает, работает и работает.
Ինչուներ Բեռնել Vivaro Sportsbook հավելվածը։ Արագությունն ու հարմարավետությունը պլյուս, ուղիղ հեռարձակվող խաղերի դիտումը պլյուս, շահումի մասին ծանոթումը պլյուս, բոնուսների ու ակցիաների մասին ծանոթումը պլյուս։ Vivaro Sportsbook եւ Android եւ iOS համակարգերի համար առանց մինուսների։ Մանրամասները vivaro.am կայքում։
Ցանկություն, գայթակղություն, շոու ծրագիր սիրված երգիչ երգչուհիների մասնակցությամբ։ Սինդի, գիշերային ակումբ արդեն նոր։ Մեսնիկյան 36, կոտորակ 3 հասցեում։ Գիշերային ակումբ Սինդի 099-90-69-69.
Незабываемый отдых в Болгарии. На курорте «Солнечный берег». Спешите заранее забронировать авиабилеты отель до 1 июля и воспользуйтесь фантастической скидкой. Бронируйте заранее и путешествуйте выгодно.
Прямые рейсы с 5 июля.
«Престиж Тур».
Залог престижного отдыха.
Саятнова, 18. Телефон 52-87-75.
Շահով այդ առաջարկը Unibank-ից բոլոր նրանց համար, ովքեր արդեն ունեն գործող հիպոտեկային վարկեր։ Տեղափոխեք ձեր վարկը Unibank 15 տարի մարման ժամկետով եւ ընդամենը 10% տարեկան տոկոսադրույքով ԱՄՆ դոլարի դեպքում։ Առաջարկը գործում է մինչև սույն թվականի հունիսի 30-ը։ Unibank 59 55 55 եւ 3w.unibank.am։
Աջարաբեթն արդեն Հայաստանում է։ Բարձր գործակիցները, տարատեսակ բոնուսներն ու շահավետ ակցիաներն արդեն սպասում են ձեզ։ Կատարեք խաղադրույք այստեղ և պարտված տոմսի դեպքում հենց ստացեք ձեր գումարի մի մասը բոնուսային ակցիայի շրջանակում։ Աջարաբեթ։
Для рекламы звоните 540002.
I'm sorry, Rafi, but I miss Steven.
Sorry, Ina, but he's gone back home.
But this is his home.
Is it?
Stepan Aritun! Homesick at home.
There's nothing you can throw at me
Rafi.
Home.
Hey, do you hear me?
Ina, I'm just trying to get home.
Donation.
Homesick at home. Homesick
at home. English speaking show.
Homesick at home, and we have two people who have been in Armenia 10 years ago, but now they're back here. I guess they were really homesick because they decided to come back. So what, Yoren, what did you miss the most about Armenia? Maybe any feelings or, I don't know, emotions or something that that were connecting you with this country?
Well, my son is Armenian, so that's, that was special, and that kind of gives us a connection to the country. And, you know, it was coming back and, you know, being able to show him Armenia as well.
Mm-hmm.
I've been lucky enough to see it once before and doing that. So that was kind of one of the things that we were longing to do.
What did you find different about Armenia after all these 10 years? Because a lot of things have changed, I guess, right?
Definitely. One of the things I remember from being here 10 years ago was how many cranes you saw in Yerevan. Mm. You walked up the Cascades and you couldn't count the number of cranes that were there. You know, and so there has been a lot of building and a lot of new buildings, new apartments, new developments, new stores. Northern Avenue wasn't there 10 years ago.
Right.
There was a street right down from the Opera House that was all just dirt, and it was being dug up and redone. That is now a nice street with lots of fancy stores and so forth. There's been big differences, and also a lot of the things have stayed the same. You know, it still feels a lot the same, even though there is obviously progress over 10 years.
So do you like this change? You like this change? There is a progress you mentioned.
I think so. No, definitely. I think so. I think 10 years ago, the other thing that we noticed that was coming from the United States was kind of startling to us was the differences. There was people who obviously had a lot of money and they were driving very expensive cars, and there was people who obviously had no money and, you know, not mm-hmm. driving cars or driving really old beat up cars, and there didn't seem to be anything in between. And I think that the difference that we're seeing now is that you're seeing a lot more people, you're seeing a lot more what we call a normal car, like a Toyota or something like that. You still see some expensive cars and you still see some old cars, but there's a lot more normal cars. So it looks like the general population of Armenia is doing a lot better, and that, you know, it seems like the economy is growing, and I think that's good. I mean, definitely good.
All those cranes must have been a really good view. One, two, three.
Hey, let's speak about your mom, okay?
Okay.
What does she do?
What does she do?
Mm-hmm.
She stays at home. She hangs out with me.
Oh.
In Armenia? Or?
In life.
What does she do?
She's
signs
a stay
me up for camps.
Home mom.
Yeah,
she did it for
mom.
You.
She does lots of stuff for me.
Amazing mom.
Since I'm an only child.
Mm-hmm. Driver, cook,
is it
laundry.
Cool? Is it cool to be a good child? An only child?
Yeah.
Would you like to have a brother or a sister sometime? Or no?
No.
No. You know, Knut, I'm an only child as well. And
I kind of
the
like
first
having
thing only. That okay. people would tell me after I told them that I was an only child. Oh, so you're spoiled. Okay, yeah. Well, I guess. I don't know. So, Knut, so you're spoiled. Well, and what do you do? Because I know that your dad travels a lot. What do you do for fun with your mom when dad is not around?
Well.
Wow.
What we do
besides
for fun.
Besides going to school and things like that.
She helps me with my homework.
Is it fun?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
We go on walk. Well, we take the dog for a walk. We hang out, watch movies. If she takes me to baseball, if I have baseball practice on that day, we just do...
You guys read?
Well, we read at night when I'm in bed, and she's extremely tired. she reads to me because I don't feel like reading.
And then you both go to sleep.
Like. Well, then she stays up for another 2 hours and does laundry, and then she goes to bed.
Very detailed. What other countries have you guys been to?
We've been to Paris for 5 hours, and then we're going to go back.
That's a lot.
Then we're going to, in like a few days, we're going back to Paris for 2 days. Then we've been to Norway, we've been to Armenia, we've been to America. Does that count?
That counts.
Wait, did you say countries?
Yeah.
That's all right.
What about Jorn? Travel a lot, right?
Yeah.
Did you get some time to spend in the countries that you go for work or?
A lot of my travel is in the United States and Canada, and we got the company I work for. We got 6 facilities spread out, so I go and visit the factories quite a bit. So you know, I go a lot back to the same places, but
they're all over the place.
Yeah. So four of them are in Canada, so I spend a lot of time in Canada. But yeah, I do get to. To go around. Unfortunately, when you travel for business, it's mostly work and not so much sightseeing and fun, but you know, every once in a while you get to do a little bit
of fun. Discovering the cultures.
Absolutely.
The cultures. How is Armenia different from any other countries that you visited? Like, what is the special things that you would like to mention, except being that old, you know, and a lot of history?
What was the question again?
How is Armenia different from other countries that you have visited?
Okay, Armenia has a very cool language. I'm not offending Norway or anything.
Yeah,
but...
What other words do you know in Armenian except Shnorakalutyun?
Oh, here we go.
Exam time.
Barev.
Right.
Vonses. See if I can. I wonder if I can count to 10. Mek, Yerku, Yerk, Chores. Hing.
Cool.
Okay, I'm gonna go up to 5. Yeah,
so you're learning. Are you trying to teach? Not teach, but get some classes of Armenians for. No, so he's somehow connected with the Armenian language and is connected to this culture. No,
we have been part of the Armenian community in St. Paul. There is an Armenian church, and so we do go to events there. But we haven't. They haven't had really good language classes to offer. You know, so it's been kind of hard to get into something that. Where you get enough practice to really learn it. You can learn a few little things, but you know, at least we want to make sure that we stay with the culture and get to remember Armenia, even when we are in the United States.
Or Norway, or Paris, or any other place on the planet.
Do you get to meet Armenian people back home?
My parents get to meet me, of course, every day.
Do you have any Armenian friends?
I have 3 Armenian friends. One is a girl. Her name is Mimi. She was actually... Wait, never mind. Then there were 2 twins. Or brothers.
Brothers.
Yeah, brothers. And they... Their names are Hakob and Armin.
The real Armenian names, yeah. Yeah, I mean, And by the way, what's your Armenian name? We didn't speak about that.
Oh, well, now it's my middle name, but...
Yeah, that's your middle name.
I am...
Ladies and gentlemen.
Ow! Vajan!
Yay! So, another real Armenian name. Go ahead. And that is really cool. So, you keep in touch with Armenians, and you have the... I know that you also guys go to Armenian church every now and then, right?
Yes, we do.
Every now and then.
Amazing. That's really neat. And what do you think you will miss the most about Armenia when you go back home?
Lavash. Well, lavash.
It's food again. What about me?
Well, our translator.
Okay, I give you a hint on that. Lavash and the translator. Cool.
Oh, and having people pick up after us at our hotel at night, so...
You could have that anywhere.
I have to pick up after myself.
At home, you do. If you go to a hotel, you get that anywhere.
Jørn.
Yeah.
And Knut. Describe your wife and your mom.
Oh, no. Dad, you go first. I need to think.
She's listening. Come on.
Yeah, she's listening. I plead the fifth. No, she is very, very nice, and she's a lot of fun, and
also a strict marshmallow.
Mm-hmm. She's a strict marshmallow, definitely. So,
your turn, Vartan.
Strict marshmallow. Is very joyful all the time, but when she's tired, she's not in a very good mood. But
all of us are not in a very good mood when we're tired. Are you in a good mood when you're tired? Right. I don't think so.
Well, I'm tired right now, and I'm in a great mood.
Yeah, you were tired this morning, and you weren't in such a great mood, so...
That was kind of boring, wasn't I?
We have a strict marshmallow, nice and kind, understanding, amazing Pam. Hello, Pam. Woo! Is there anything you would like to add to our show? Because our show came to an end. 1 hour, it's gone. Is there anything you want to ask? Maybe? 1 more minute to go. And that's it.
You ask.
What's wrong with you? Do I get to take this microphone home?
No.
It was a question.
That's a pretty cool microphone, isn't it? You have fun with that.
Okay, guys. Thanks for being in our studio tonight.
Thank you for having us.
We discovered some more about Remem family and the story how you guys met. I never heard that. And that Knut played in the band and sang the song. Stressed out. Cool. So we have to follow this guy because I bet pretty soon he's going to become a really famous actor. A comedian, a singer, right?
Like, follow me? How follow me? Like, follow me around wherever I go? Follow me on Twitter?
Follow him everywhere.
Oh, no.
This was Homesick at Home, our English-speaking show. We're on air every Friday from 9 to 10 p.m. And I'd like to remind you that you can always watch and listen us live on our Facebook page, and also you can download an application and listen to our radio station anywhere you go in the world. Also, for those of us who missed our show and you would like to catch up and hear this guy speak on air, we're gonna post a recording of this show in a couple of days or even tomorrow. So follow our page.
Woohoo!
And stay safe. Have a great Friday night and have an amazing weekend. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.